Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the Director of ChassisSim Technologies. Welcome to this latest ChassisSim video tutorial. Today, what we're going to be talking about is how you can use ChassisSim to help nail down things such as your roll sensors, your pitch sensors, and what the cambers are doing on the car. Now, just a quick sort of disclaimer to what we're about to do. I want to state very, very clearly that tools such as ChassisSim do not replace tools such as SUSPROG or WinGeo, for instance. As far as I'm concerned, tools such as SUSPROG and WinGeo are valuable additions to any race engineer's toolbox, because in particular, in addition to doing things such as roll center locations, pitch center locations, they also go into much greater depth than what ChassisSim does on the kinematic side of things. And so I would really commend those tools to any engineering toolbox. And as you're about to see, they're actually very complementary tools to what I'm about to show you. That being said, because of what ChassisSim does, there's a lot of crossovers between the two, and particularly as we're about to see in the suspension geometry interface. You can use the suspension geometry interface to come up with some really good first cut approximations for what you want your geometry to look at, and then you can go back and use tools such as WinGeo and SUSPROG to get a more detailed picture, and then you put that back in the ChassisSim, and then you can run some simulations to see what it actually did on track. So as far as I'm concerned, the two tools go hand in hand. So let's get started. First of all, to edit suspension geometry in ChassisSim, we click on the double wishbones, or we go into the suspension geometry tab and go down the tree structure. So let me click here to adjust the points. Now, you will see that with ChassisSim, we've got a number of different suspension geometry options. We've got double wishbone with first and struts. We've got a rear end live axle four length, a rear end live axle free length, the Ferrari 458 multi-link rear end, the BMW Z4 multi-link rear end, and a double wishbone with the toe link. So, as we can see, what we've got here is that we've got our point coordinate system. Now, in ChassisSim, your datum is the front axle center line of the car on the ground. I cannot stress that point highly enough. And all you've got to do in this particular example is that you fill in your X points, which go back along the car, your Y points, which are the lateral coordinates, which go positive to the right, and your Z coordinates that go up. Now, a quick point for those of you who are involved in asymmetric setups. Always put in your Y points as positive. ChassisSim will handle the rest once it actually goes internally into the car. So once you've done all that and you've entered in your points, you click on Analyze Configuration. Now, the thing that I really like about the Analyze Configuration tab is it's a very, very quick way of seeing what's going on with your particular geometry at that particular point in time. So for example, if I want to say raise 0.2 by about 10 mil, I can just put that at 198, and then I can click on Analyze Configuration, and that showed me what the difference was in terms of the roll center and the anti-dive. And when we're done with that, I'm just going to put that back to standard for the time being. We can click on Apply Calc. That applies the calculation, and then we go to OK. Now, one of the great things about ChassisSim is that, let's just say that you're playing around with a number of different configurations. We can click on export settings and go into, say, ChassisSim Technologies, go into my models directory, go into, say, Formula 3, and I'll just put in a little tab here called Suspension Geometry. And I'm just going to call that F3 front standard, and I'm going to call that my standard suspension geometry. Click on OK, and that's exported that out. And the great thing about that is that you can use that for a variety of configurations. So that means that so if you're going to a new configuration, you don't have to re-enter all this in. All you've got to do is click on Import Settings, select that, and away you go. Now, one point that I do want to make really, really clearly, the other advantage of this is that particularly if you combine that with the ChassisSim scripting, all of a sudden you can come up with a huge library of points that you can readily access. Now, one of the other things that ChassisSim brings to the party is this little tool here called Suspension Analysis. So in the Geometry tab, you click on Suspension Analysis, and it will load the current default geometry. So if we click on the roll center, there you go. And what you can do is you can set in your input parameters, such as what your roll bounds are going to be, your pitch bounds are going to be, your left and your right bounds. And these are specified as movement at the wheel as opposed to movement at the damper. And you can go through and look at things like what your camber gain is doing. And you can go and the beauty about this is that as you go through and change geometries, you can take a look at what, say, the roll center migration is and what the camber migration is. Now, again, let me stress, this does not replace tools such as SUSPROG and WinGeo. That being said, you've got a really great little tool in the ChassisSim environment where you can go through and see what a change actually did. However, to quote the famous old saying, but wait, there's more. Whenever you run a ChassisSim simulation, it will actually return the force-based roll centers, the force-based pitch centers, and what your camber values are doing. So let me illustrate that. So what we've got here is some simulated data, and let me go in and show you what that. Let me show you what's going on. So here, what we've got is we've got what our front left and our front right cambers were doing, what our rear left and rear right cambers are doing, what our front and rear roll centers are doing, what the front pitch sensors were doing, and what the rear pitch sensors were doing. Now, let me state these are all force-based roll centers, but this is the sort of material that you are going to get back. So when you do a suspension geometry change and you've gone through, you used the ChassisSim geometry tools, you've used tools such as SUSPROC and WinGeo to determine what you think is your optimum suspension characteristic. You can then run the simulation using either the lifetime simulation or using the open loop simulation. It really doesn't matter. It's totally it's totally up to you to see what that configuration actually did. The other spin-off of this is that using these tools, say for example, you've got a setup that you ran and you wanted to see what the cambers were doing. Well, one of the great advantages of the open loop simulation is this will return this as a matter of course. So you've got that at your fingertips. Okay, so let's wrap that. Wrapping all this up, the great thing about ChassisSim is that you can use the analyze configuration to get a very, very a quick snapshot of what your geometry change did. You can then use the suspension analysis tab to quickly plot what it did. And then when you run a simulation, you can see what the front left and rear left cambers are doing. So that gives you a very, very powerful tool to truly investigate not just the changes of what your suspension geometry will do, but really to quantify what it actually did. So if you're already a member of the ChassisSim community, give this a run. Really make good use of it. If you're not a member of the ChassisSim community, check out our online simulation and give this a test drive for yourself. And we'll catch you in the next episode of either Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner or the next ChassisSim video tutorial.